Good morning students. Today we are going to learn about our second lesson, plants living and surviving. In this lesson we are going to learn about the plants and how they survive in different areas. Survive means live in different condition. So let's start. Plants can grow almost everywhere. Plants grow on mountain slopes, on ocean beds, in deserts and in river valleys. In fact, they grow almost everywhere. Here also we can see in the picture plants have grown on the stone, on the wall, stones of the temple we can see here. From that stones, the growth of plants we can see. So plants can grow almost everywhere. Let us read about them. Plants differ. Differ means are different from each other depending on the surroundings where they grow. Suppose plants on hilly areas, how they grow, and plants in water, how they grow. We can see the difference. According to their location or according to their surrounding, plants are divided into some types. So we will learn about them. Here we can see the types of plants. First is terrestrial plants, second is aquatic plants, third plants of the grass family, fourth unusual plants. In first part we will going to learn about plants which grow on land, in hilly areas, in the plains, in hot and damp areas, in deserts and in marshy areas. In aquatic plants we are going to learn about plants which grow in water, means floating plants, fixed plants and underwater plants. Plants of the grass family, about them also we are going to learn. They are cereals, sugarcane, bamboo, papyrus grass and medicinal grass. There are some unusual plants also, about them also we are going to learn. So let's learn. First of all, terrestrial plants. Terrestrial means living on land. Plants that grow on land are called as a terrestrial plants. Once again, terrestrial means living on land. So plants which grow in hilly areas. Hilly areas means on the hill. On hills it is generally cold and trees are tall and straight also. So these trees have needle like leaves. Why they have needle like leaves? Because on the hills we can see that snowfall is there, heavy snowfall is there, and suppose that snowfall is remain as it is on the tree because of the broad and flat leaves. So that tree after some days will die. So to avoid this, that tree have needle like leaves. If you want to keep something on the needle, can it stay or can it be there for a long time? No, on needle we cannot keep for a long time. So same as needle like leaves also support to plant to remove the snowfall from the plant. Instead of flowers, these trees bears cones. Here we can see that brown colored cones are present, and in that cones seeds of the trees are there. So the examples of this kind of trees means hilly areas trees are pine, fir. We can observe their needle like leaves. Here are more examples of the trees which grows on hilly areas. They are also have needle-like leaves. Spruce trees, cedar means devdar in Hindi. Second type of the terrestrial plant is the trees which grows in the plain areas. We are also living in the plain areas, so we know which kind of trees are present in the plain areas. In the plains, trees have lots of branches. Have you observed the mango tree, peepal tree or banyan tree? These trees have lots of branches and lots of leaves. So these trees shed their leaves during winter. Shed their leaves means the leaves of the tree falls down during the winter. Observe the picture. Here are some more examples of trees of terrestrial plant which grows in plain area. Sisam and sal. These also grow on plain areas or in the plains. In hot and damp areas, how the trees are? In hot and damp areas, trees have lots of leaves, but they don't shed their leaves. Means in particular season, the leaves does not fall down. When fully leaves grown, at that time they fell down. But at a particular season, they don't fall down from the trees. Here are some examples: coconut tree, teak tree, and rubber tree. They all belong to hot and damp areas. Here are some more examples of the trees which grow in hot and damp areas: coffee, paper, cotton. These belongs to hot and damp area. They do not shed their leaves. That's why these trees remain evergreen. Means whole year we can see that trees with green leaves. In deserts, most plants grow without leaves. They have spines instead of leaves, and these spines prevent the loss of water. Everybody know the cactus? Here we can see the cactus with lots of spines. Why the cactus have spines instead of leaves? Because that spines prevent the loss of water. And if the cactus plant don't have leaves, then how cactus plant prepare its own food? We can observe one more green thing is present in the cactus plant. Yes, its stem. Cactus plant have green fleshy stem that cactus plant have green and fleshy stem. In that, water is stored, and this stem prepares the food for the plant. Here we can observe the picture. In marshy areas means near the West Bengal, we can see that area. The soil is sticky and clayey. That's why the plants that grow here have the special feature developed in them, and these plants are called as mangroves. Their roots do not get air as the soil is sticky, clayey and covered with water. So the roots grow out of the soil and water to breathe, and such roots are called as a breathing root. Observe the picture. We can see the roots which grow above the ground. These are breathing roots. Now, second type of plants are aquatic plants. Aqua means water. So, the plants that grow in water are called as a aquatic plant. First part or first type of aquatic plant is floating plants. These plants float because they are either light or small in size. Suppose the plants are heavy like a mango tree. Can it float on the water? No. The mango plant cannot float on the water. So here some examples are duckweed plant, water lettuce and water hyacinth plant. If you observe that plant, we can see they are very light and they are very small in size. That's why they can float in water. Fixed plant. This is also type of aquatic plant. Why it is called as a fixed plant? Because these plants float on water, but their roots are fixed in the bed of pond. Some plants are fixed to the bed of the pond. They have floating leaves and have stomata only on the upper side. Do you have seen the lotus plant or water lily? The stem of lotus plant is hollow, and hollow means like a pipe, and light in weight, which keeps the leaves and the flowers afloat. This is also used to make tasty dishes. Stem of the lotus plant also used as a food item, and from that stem people make tasty dishes. The leaves of this kind of plant are broad and have stomata only on the upper side. These broad floating leaves provide a nesting place for some tiny birds. Means suppose a tiny bird is searching for insect near the water. After getting tired, that bird can stay on the leaves of fixed plant for some time. So here are the example of fixed plant, lotus plant and water lily plant. Do you remember what is meant by stomata? We have learned about the stomata in third standard. Stomata means the leaves or the plant breathe through the stomata. It is present in each and every leaf. Plants breathe through only stomata. Means we can say that stomata is the nose of the plant. Here in the picture we can observe. In first figure we can see that green leaf have stomata, and in second figure actual stoma we can see. So plants breathe through the stomata, and lotus plant have the stomata on the upper side of the leaf. Underwater plant. This is the third type of aquatic plants. These plants remain underwater. These plants have long ribbon-like narrow leaves and have no stomata at all. These plants never comes in contact with air, or sometime it came also, but they don't have stomata. They breathe through their body surface. Body surface means through their leaves and stems. So here are some examples of underwater plants: hydrilla, tape grass, pondweed, These are the examples of underwater plant. These plants have long ribbon like narrow leaves, we can see. Second picture, we can see it very clearly. These leaves arrives in cluster from the roots and they grows like the same. They don't have branches. Observe the picture. These green plants clean the water by removing the carbon dioxide breathed out by aquatic animals. Aquatic animals means fish, turtles, and so many. We already know that when animals breathe out carbon dioxide in the air. And that carbon dioxide is used by the plants, and plants gives us oxygen. So same procedure is happening underwater also. Underwater plants also using the carbon dioxide breathed out by the aquatic animals, and they give fresh air or oxygenated air to the aquatic animals. So that is why whenever we see the aquarium, in that aquarium we can see these kinds of grass. Now the plants of the grass family. First is cereals. Wheat, bajra, jwari, rice, these all are grass. So these grasses are belong to grass family, are called as cereals. These cereals provide food for the humans and fodder for animals. Animals also eat them. Sugarcane. Sugarcane is also grass. Sugar is obtained from the sugarcane. Bamboo. Bamboo plants are also grass. Actually giant grass. Giant means very big or very huge. Bamboo is used for making many things. Here in the second picture we can see so many things are prepared by the bamboo, like brooms, baskets, chairs, mats, curtains, toys also prepared by the bamboo plant. So bamboo is useful for us in many ways. Bamboo shoots have a high nutritional value and rich in vitamins. So in northeast side especially, bamboo shoots are used to prepare tasty dishes. Here we can see first picture, newly grown bamboo shoots are there. In second picture we can see bamboo shoots. And in third picture, we can see the dish of bamboo shoot. Now, various kinds of grasses are now used for making paper. Means grass also useful for making paper. Do you know, paper was first made by the people of Egypt from a grass called papyrus. Here in this picture, we can see the grass. It is called as a papyrus. From papyrus, the word came, and we can see that thing as a paper. From papyrus comes the word paper. Here we can see how that paper is made from this grass. Some plants of the grass family are used in preparing medicines. Durva. Everybody knows about the Durva. Lord Ganesha also like Durva. Lemongrass. Lemongrass is used to prepare green tea. Some people prepare tea from this lemongrass. Nagarmotha. Nagarmotha also medicinal grass. So these are the examples of grass which used as medicines. Dried grass is used as packing material. We can observe the picture and we can see that mangoes are packed safely inside the box by using that grass. The roots of the plant of the grass family help to bind the soil. Here also we can see how the roots have binded that soil. Some unusual plants. The plants which eat to insects are called as a insectivorous plants. Here are the examples of these plants. First is Venus flytrap. The leaf of Venus flytrap is folded into two halves. One is half and two halves. When an insect sits on the leaf, the two halves close and insect is trapped inside the Venus flytrap plant. And that will be eaten by the plant. The pitcher plant and the sundew plant are other examples of insectivorous plants. They also trap to insect and eat to them. Rainforest. Rainforest are hot and wet forest that are found mostly near the equator. Most rainforest exist in parts of Asia, Africa, South America and Australia. In rainforest, there are both tall and short trees with lots of climbers around it. Observe the picture, we can see short trees, we can see long trees, we can see climbers. So in rainforest, we can see all varieties of all types of plants. The ground of the rainforest is covered with leaves. In first picture we can see that how that leaves are fell down on the ground of the rainforest and we can not see the soil. Only leaves we can see. Ferns also. Fern is a type of tree. In rainforest we can see them. Fungi or fungi, we can see them in rainforest. The ground of the rainforest is covered with this fungi also. Mushrooms are fungi. Here we can see different kinds of mushrooms. In rainforest we can see many types of or varieties of these mushrooms. Some are eatable and some are very poisonous for us. This mushrooms or this fungi is present on the ground, on the bark of tree or on the dead tree. It is present everywhere. The thick growth of leaves of the plants of rainforest has an umbrella-like shape. So, this umbrella-like shape of leaf or leaves creates dark areas underneath the leaf. A wide variety of animals are found here. Here we can see some animals which are present only in the rainforest. Now here is a quick recap of the lesson. Plants have different features to suit their natural surroundings. In hilly areas, plants have needle-like leaves. In the plains, plants have lots of branches. In deserts, plants have no leaves at all. The plants that grow in marshy areas are called as mangroves. They have breathing roots. Aquatic plants. Aquatic plants can float or stay underwater. Plants of grass family are useful to us in many ways. And last, insectivorous plants eat insect. So these are the points regarding to our lesson. I hope you will understand all the points. Thank you.